Thank you. In those last few moments of his wretchedness, he considered the ruin that was his life. He remembered everything he'd built up or torn down. He remembered the red brick house from where he came. He remembered his father's strong hands that held him, the sweet, sickly smell of his mother's flesh, squeezing tight as she nursed him through thunderstorms. He recalled his wife, prostrate and bellowing on a hospital bed, and the slithering thing that was his son, fighting for the first breath of air. He remembered yesterday's quarrel and the cuts on his hands. And then he remembered he was here in this motel room, interned with a black and white mannequin, poised at the brink of deliverance, 3 feet away from a cold steel rail. He took a step forward, across the wall, parched and waiting like some mad creature of prey. Pariah's scarred lips gaped, exposing a fence of daggers. Her cat's eyes glittered as she extended a claw, and with a terminal click, switched out the light.